What is happening, gamers? This is Bradley here, and welcome back to another news roundup. Indiki Kazawa said just yesterday, the official Japanese Twitter account for Hyrule Warriors teased that there was a 98% chance that we'd be hearing about a new playable character in this week's issue of Famitsu. And with the whole mention of the 98% probability, it makes you think of the character Fi from Skyward Sword. And wouldn't you know, the new character is Fi. At this point, we don't know too much on how Fi will actually play, but she might be a quick and agile character, because in Skyward Sword she did move around like a ballerina, so they might translate that over into Hyrule Warriors. It is interesting to note that 6 female characters and 1 male character have been confirmed so far, so there are a healthy amount of female representatives, but it was confirmed in the Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3 2014 that half of the roster will be female, so there definitely will be some more male representatives, and I'm calling it right now, the Happy Mouse Salesman will be playable. But besides Fi, it was also confirmed that Ghirahim and the Imprisoned from Skyward Sword will also be making appearances as enemies in Hyrule Warriors, and whether or not Ghirahim will turn into a playable character after you beat him, we don't know. And we also know now that Link and Zelda will receive costumes for their Skyward Sword counterparts, Link will be able to use the ball and chain item from Twilight Princess, and the Famitsu scan even shows Zelda wielding the well-known Wind Waker baton from, of course, the Wind Waker. I am getting fairly excited for Hyrule Warriors, and it'll be interesting to see what other references they will make to the Zelda series. And hey, maybe they'll include some characters from the 2D Zelda games, like Vaati or something. And from there, the Mega Man-inspired side-scrolling action title Mighty No. 9 is in the news as of recently, as Concept has decided to open up another funding campaign for the title, despite it already raising around $4 million. This has definitely received some mixed reactions, as why would they need to open up another funding campaign when they already got a ton of money? Well, Concept has addressed that concern. So basically, they're not looking to raise more money because they mismanaged their funds somehow. All the money they received through Kickstarter will be going towards the full game and all the stretch goals that they promised. But they are feeling ambitious and are open to adding some more content, which is why they have started a new funding campaign where you can pledge some more money via PayPal. And that means we're getting new stretch goals, with the first one being set at $200,000 where we'll get full Japanese and English voice acting for Mighty No. 9. I do kind of think that people are blowing this out of proportion. I mean, we don't need to pledge anything. Even if they don't raise a ton of money, we're still going to get the game they promised in the spring of 2015. But whatever. And finally, it's been confirmed that Dragon Quest X will be making its way to the Nintendo 3DS on September 4th in Japan. Dragon Quest X originally released on Wii and Wii U, but now it's coming to Nintendo's handheld. And what's interesting about it is that it'll be played through cloud functionality, so it'll run on a server through Square Enix. This is definitely different from how 3DS games are usually played, and this is pretty much the first time a developer has done this for Nintendo's handheld, and one would hope that Square Enix executes it well. Oh, and also, 3DS users will be able to play with other people who have different versions of Dragon Quest X, so there's that too. At this point, the 3DS version of Dragon Quest X will stay in Japan, and there's no word of it getting localized. But that will bring us to the end of the news roundup. If you like what you saw, please give it a thumbs up and add your favorites and all that good stuff, and you can stay tuned for more news videos, video reviews, and that's on Mirror's episodes in the future. I am thinking about doing a skit that is a parody of Skyward Sword, so that could be something that you can look forward to in the future. And also the 30th episode of That's on Mirror's will be going up this Saturday, so you can stay tuned for that. But I will talk to you later in the next video, guys. Bye!